Hello and greetings from Iceland. The second eruption of 2024 has just begun. It started 6 o'clock this morning. And as usual, I'm leaving links to all available webcams and not going deep into technicalities right now, other than to say that the amount of magma that accumulated by Svartsengi in the magma chamber or magma sill near the Blue Lagoon was estimated to be around 9 million cubic meters yesterday, or just about what that magma chamber can hold. So when it filled up, it pressurized, the magma took off to the dike, and the earthquakes started 30 minutes before the eruption. And 10 minutes after the earthquake started, the power plant could detect what was about to take place. Not for the first time, actually. And the eruption is still very impressive, as they always are at the beginning, but we suspect that this will soon fade out. And before I talk about the location or how lucky or unlucky we got this time, I need to mention the tourism and keeping it short and sweet. No interruptions at all when it comes to international flights, business as usual at the airport, and the fissure is for the most part at the same location as in December, but only shorter now, 3 kilometers in total. So we have engineers running computer models now to see where the lava will flow, but from the photos that we already have and videos, the lava has already reached the highway to the Blue Lagoon and Grindavík, and it is currently flowing over the intersection down to the Blue Lagoon. But in order to see the wider picture a bit better, let's move to my own footage shot a while ago. The lava is coming down here and we can see the lava barrier and the gap that was left open for traffic, but that is being filled up right now. The barrier is there to protect the power plant and the Blue Lagoon, which is Iceland's most popular tourist destination. Very important part of our tourism infrastructure, and the barrier is also protecting the power plant that is the main power source for Grindavík and supplies the town with not only hot water and cold water but electricity as well. And within those barriers are around 1500 jobs. So this is going to be a good test for the lava protection walls, and this is where things might get very tense in the next 48 hours, I think, or if the fissure won't extend to the south closer to town, which is still a possibility, but every passing hour the risk gets less. So most likely this eruption, the third since December, will be all about to protect infrastructure. And if those lava barriers don't hold long enough, we are talking about yet another major disaster. So let's hope they do. And I am actually quite hopeful that they will do so. When we look at the other eruptions, this might be over next weekend, and this might even start to throttle down in just a few hours. We are, however, in this vicious cycle and inflow to this magma dike will most likely go on, and we will get stuck with eruptions of this kind every few weeks or so, or unless the inflow to this magma chamber stops. And although it's a bit scary to see the magma come crawling down to the barriers, it would take it several days to flow over them to ruin the infrastructure there. And I don't think that this eruption alone is enough to do so. But the other eruptions that might come later on, that's another story, of course. And as I promised, as soon as I finish this upload, I will be on the road, on the way to Reykjavík, since I live up north. The eruption takes place only 20-30 minutes away from the metropolitan area. As always, there are lots of restrictions as for how close I can get, so I'm not expecting any close-ups, but I do hope for scenarios where my DSLR and my long-range drone can come up with something. And this is eruption number 6 that I cover on the channel. So even though this is not the biggest event we have seen so far, it is important for me to have footage from all those events, since at some time point all those vlogs I've been doing about this will be good material for a documentary, or so I believe. And finally, I want to thank my channel supporters for making this possible, and until my next update, you can find the links to Icelandic news sources in the video description, and with that I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.